A lively debate in the European Parliament as MEPs discussed Russia's annexation of Ukraine's Crimean Peninsula. The commissioner who oversees EU membership bids reiterated the bloc's unwavering support for Ukraine. But some parliamentarians went further to say more needs to be done.
It is not enough for us to merely award Sakharov Prize to those like Oleg Sentsov, who have been fighting this repression. No, it is important that we instead send a strong message to Russia that ignoring international law has consequences, whilst also providing more help to Ukraine for their security.
Tensions at the debate reached boiling point as several MEPs confronted Jean-Luc Schaffhauser, a member of France's far-right National Front, over his party's ties to the Kremlin. Romanian Christian Dan Preda asked this question.
Mr. Schaffhauser, you've been here for 5 years and you're passionately in favor of everything the Kremlin says. So, during these 5 years, has there any position from Putin or his regime that you have not agreed with? Have you ever disagreed with him on one little thing, one tiny little thing? Are you really 120% behind Mr. Putin and the Kremlin? Please tell us the truth.
Mr. Schaffhauser claimed in response he supports the politics of France. The National Front MEP was the only one to voice his backing for Russia's occupation of Crimea. Meanwhile, Estonian MEP Tuni Kelam, who played a crucial role in his country's strive for independence during Soviet occupation, said there can be no return to a business-as-usual attitude until the Kremlin restores the territorial integrity of Europe. He drew parallels between Russia's aggression in Ukraine and events which unfolded in 1938.
Annexation of Crimea by force 5 years ago, breaking blatantly international order, can only be compared to the Anschluss of Austria by Hitler 81 years ago. And thus, Anschluss paved the way to further aggression for the Great War. Yes, the Russian aggression has been condemned and sanctions established. Hesitations and differences of opinion have weakened their credibility and impact.
Earlier this month, the EU extended sanctions against Russia and added 8 more individuals to the list, bringing it to 162 people.